Okay, hello everyone. I hope you hear me. So today I have my honor to have Edis, our instructor from Austria, and today we go to ex I will give you a tip how to teach a female knife defense. Okay, look, it's not a secret to see the size different here. Okay, I'll show you my opinion what you should not to teach a female when it's come to for her to defense herself against knife threat. Okay, so first of all, if she facing somebody come with the knife to the throat and if she try to move only using the hands, okay, so move the knife, okay, move, okay, and try from here go to strike my nose or open palm, okay. I don't think this is going to be a good idea for her to try, okay. Remember, the moment she touch, yeah, no, but do it from here and that's it. Try to hold as tight as possible and move the knife. That's it. Again, good. Again, okay, action, yeah, try. Okay. Now you can also smash my face. No, but connect with my face. And it's got to finish in a bad situation, not towards the attacker, towards Edith. Okay, so of course the female will feel very empowered if I will tell her move the hand, strike, one, another one, two, three, yeah, for me to kick the groin and run away and leave the arms and that, and lock or not lock, she will feel very much empowered because it's feel like
I will
I'm
feel
strong,
good.
I can do it. The things we need to understand, if I am attacker and I'm attacking Edith, okay, I will be more on that behavior. Hey, don't resist me. Don't fucking resist me, huh? Where's your stuff, huh? Where's your fucking stuff? And if she try now to do this what she learned, palm strike and move, okay? So you can move and strike my face. Hey, what's your fucking problem, huh? And that's it. This is when she will die. Now, I understand a female want a space. Okay, I understand they don't like this close distance. But now I don't care as instructor what she like. Me, if I care about her life, I will explain to her I will explain few things to her. First of all, I will tell her, listen, it's all about chance, and the chance is slim, okay? Of course, I will tell her as a man believe in God, I will tell her you need God with you if you decide to take action against somebody with the knife larger from you, stronger from you, okay? Easy, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen, okay? And you will need to work against your instinct, the instinct of just to move the knife out and try to strike him, okay? It's not going to work. So, what we teach, okay? I teach find the control of the arms, okay? Go to the color control. Okay. Now, let's see for how long she can hold it. I will not go to move too much because we're using one camera, but okay, I use the same force, okay? I'm using, okay, now, that, the normal thing. Hold, tight. Again, tight. Okay, so you can see the difference between have good control. I don't say I cannot lift her up, but she can hold it. Meaning, if she can hold, she has more seconds in life to fight, to do things. Let's do it slow, such as she can bite the arms, she can kick the groin, not only one, few of them. She can give a low headbutt to the chin, that's it, because she's small. Yeah, she even can shout to help.
Help!
because she doesn't have control. Okay, so she can do something about that. Now, if it's against the instinct to put her body on me, definitely, definitely she don't got to like it. Definitely got to be more complicated. Not complicated, more difficult. But definitely when she sit in the car, when she driving home after session, she will say, sure, that is very difficult. Or I can think about, I want just your money, fuck your life, don't worry, just move, slow, strike my nose a few times, that's it, kick, that's it, and run away. Then she will drive at home with this confidence, that be cool session, that be fun session, I can do it. No, you can't.
It's not true.
Okay, it's not true. Now, before we finish, let's talk about the switch. Okay, the attacker switch right to left. So if you do the first one, yes, and strike at the same time, and I pull, now I can switch the knife, and she's still in the line of fire. She don't have any control or nothing. When she has the control, the kala control, and even if I'm shifting, she can, she have more, even if I take the knife, okay, and let's say I start to do that to the back. I don't say she cannot get cut or step, but you tell me, where's more fatal step? Do the wrist? Okay, or do the kala control? That's it. Or this kind of stabbing. I say the second is better. Okay? I don't say she will not be cut or not bleed. Okay? She will. The thing is what is the level of the injuries? Are they fatal? Or they are injuries she can deal by grace of God? Is injuries when that the adrenaline can hold her? She losing blood, but not too much? Okay, this is the question. And the last thing for the people thinks the best knife against, the best defense against knife is to run. If somebody here holding you a knife, okay, you're not running nowhere. If you carry a firearms condition one or condition whatever, don't go to your gun, okay? So put everything in perspective. Okay, if somebody put a knife back to your life, submit,
please.
Find
please.
The control first. Slow, please. This is the full control. The first things you want to do. Because now she can give one groin, you still pull, oh, good headbutt, biting. Even if I'm here and I punch her, she's close to me, just like that, don't hit me. Even if I punch, I don't say it's got to be, not to be so, but she close, it's more difficult for me to give solid, more hard punches from she just, hold here, look at the punch now. Look this power, I mean, come on. So, to close this video, you cannot teach a woman or a man, I don't care, easy way to defend against knife. It's mean, if you rely on one strike in the nose to solve the problem, think again. God bless you. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you, Edith.